I'm Tom, and today I'm going to talk about polycarbonate. Now, polycarbonate, or short PC, is one of the highest performance plastics out there, both in terms of strength and temperature resistant. It's also optically clear, which makes it ideal for things like shatterproof sunglasses, face shields, protective glasses, or even as a component in bulletproof windows. It's also often used in composites where glass or carbon fibers are added to make the material even stronger and stiffer. For 3D printing, you'll probably be using polycarbonate without fiber additions, but just by itself, polycarbonate is already a pretty impressive material. It is a bit stiffer than ABS, but not quite as hard as PLA. It has an enormous amount of layer bonding, and it takes way higher forces to break a printed part than one made from normal plastics. Even getting the brim off your print can be quite challenging. Now, polycarbonate isn't a new material. Ritrap has been printing polycarbonate since 2011, but it isn't really popular yet either. And that has a couple of reasons. First of all, I already mentioned that it is a very temperature stable material with a glass transition temperature of about 150 degrees Celsius compared to 100 degrees for ABS or just above 60 degrees for PLA. But that also means that you'll have to print polycarbonate at much higher temperatures. You can extrude it as cold as 260 degrees Celsius, but at that temperature, it has almost no layer adhesion. So realistically, you'll be printing polycarbonate beyond 300 degrees Celsius, which simply isn't something that normal hardens that use PTFE or PEEK in the heated parts can handle. I mostly use 315 degrees Celsius. You will need an all-metal harden and possibly a specialized thermistor or another way of measuring the hardened temperature, since even the stock thermistor of the E3D V6 is only rated for up to 300 degrees Celsius. Now, the thermistor probably won't spontaneously combust at 301 degrees Celsius, but it will have a reduced accuracy and a shorter lifespan at those temperatures. You might also want to retighten your nozzle once the harden is up to temp for the first time to keep it from oozing out in the wrong spots. The other thing that I found extremely challenging was getting my prints to stick to the build plate. I tried glue stick, Captain, PET tape and ABS glue slurry stuff, and the only ones of those that worked somewhat decently were PET tape and, to a lesser degree, Captain tape. Bed temperatures of 120 or 140 degrees Celsius made very little difference, and while smaller and weaker prints like this octopus worked pretty well on PET tape at 125 degrees Celsius, stronger parts like the Formlabs Rook detached mid-print every single time. Captain has a bit of an advantage here since the parts stay stuck to the tape while the tape itself lifts off of the bed. But neither are ideal, and that, I think, is the biggest downside to polycarbonate. Of course, you could use a polycarbonate sheet and print onto that, but to keep your prints from permanently bonding to the sheet, you'd have to apply the exact right amount of hairspray or some other release agent to it, and still wouldn't have a surface that reliably works each time. One other thing that was quite nasty about polycarbonate was the smell, because it smells like sweet burnt rubber, and going by what I've read about it so far, also releases quite a lot of particles into the air, so it's probably not something you want to be in the same room with while it's printing. You should also open your windows, even if it's cold outside. Yes, but you just should do that. Polycarbonate seems to require a minimum speed to print well. If you go too slow, it will start bubbling up and turn your print from clear to opaque white. On the other hand, if you print too fast, the filament might kink in the extruder and the layers of the finished print will have less adhesion to each other. But a slightly larger extrusion width can help with that, especially for things like vases. And while the acetone vapor method works pretty well for smoothing out ABS prints, you will need MEK to dissolve or smooth polycarbonate, and that is basically a stronger and nastier version of acetone. Acetone by itself will instantly make polycarbonate brittle instead of dissolving it. The thing is though, you will rarely need to smooth out polycarbonate prints, since the prints just by themselves will usually look very, very clean without any post-processing. Now, this might all sound like polycarbonate is something that you wouldn't really want to use. And it's true, it's not ever going to replace ABS or PLA as a daily driver filament. But just like nylon, it's a material that is well suited for specialty applications, especially for those where nylon is too soft. I'll be using it for 1/10 scale RC car spares, where using printed ABS parts instead of the original composite parts just doesn't feel quite right. Because of its neat optical properties, polycarbonate is also well suited for glowy things, but PET filaments like Colorfab XT or Tame and T-Glaze are probably the better choice for those things, since PET is actually printable. So it really boils down to high temp or high strength parts, and even there's some competition. Tame are now offering Triton Filament, and from what I've seen about that, it seems to be a very promising plastic that is much more printable than polycarbonate while only lacking the extreme temperature resistance. I'm still waiting to get some Triton and will post a comparison once I've tried it out. So there you have it, polycarbonate right now is both a solution and source of problems, but it is a pretty neat material for the right applications. And it's not even that much more expensive than a regular filament. So thank you E3D for sending me a roll of polycarbonate a while back, I just now got around to trying it out. If you want to purchase some, I've put some links in the description where you can do just that. Before you ask, no, I cannot share the file for the Form Labs Rook. That file was given to me so that I'd be able to run some direct comparisons to the sample part they are handing out. I was going to do a quick mechanical test in the same way I did for PLA, ABS, nylon, and the Formlabs part itself in the plastic destruction video, but I just didn't manage to print a complete Rook from polycarbonate without it detaching from the build plate. So that's it for today. Please do not hesitate to use those like, share, and subscribe buttons on the YouTube page. And as always, thanks for watching. See you next week.